अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप सो ऑल ऑफ़ यू आर फाइन एंड एंजॉइंग योर हॉलीडेज विद गुड हेल्थ. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 8, दैट इज़ अबाउट द ज्योमेट्री. वी विल डू सम क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज नंबर 8.1 टुडे. द टॉपिक इज अबाउट द सिमिलैरिटी एंड कॉन्ग्रेंसी ऑफ डिफरेंट ज्योमेट्रिकल फिगर्स. स्टूडेंट्स, इन डेली लाइफ यू आर हैविंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फिगर्स. We can say them some are similar and some are congruent. Now, first of all, we will discuss what are the similar figures. Students, this is the symbol for the similar figures and this is the symbol for the congruent figures. First of all, what are the similar figures? In similar figures, you are having the same shape but not the same size. Means that if the size of the figures are different and the shape is exactly same, then you can say that these are similar figure. But if the size and shape both are exactly same, then you can say that they are congruent figures. Suppose I'm taking this type of shapes. These are two, you can see that these are two triangles, but this one is bigger and this one is smaller. You can see that these two are of same shape, but their size is different. So these are the similar figure. So, but if we are considering these two shapes, now you can see that exactly their size and their shape are same. So we can say that these are the two congruent figures. Let's take another example. Suppose I'm discussing about these two. Again, you can see that. Yes, students, what type of figures are these? Yes, good. These are the similar figures. You can see that their size is different, but their shape is exactly same. So these are the similar figure. But students, if I am comparing these two figures, what will be they? Yes, good. These will not be similar, not be congruent. Means there is no relation between these two. Means this is not similar because obviously the shape is different and obvious size is different. Now, strength from these figures, you can guess every congruent figure can be similar, but every similar figure cannot be congruent. Why? Because you can see these are just similar figures, but their size is different. In congruent figures, we should have the same size also. So these are only similar figures, but not the congruent. But if we are taking this example, you can see that these two are similar as well as congruent. So we will say that these two are congruent figures, right? Means their size and shape is same. So these are congruent figures. It's mean every congruent figure is also similar, but every similar is not congruent. Okay, students, the next topic is one-to-one correspondence. What is one-to-one correspondence? Means if you are considering or if we are comparing any two different geometrical figures, then we can take one-to-one correspondence between them. Like if I'm again taking these two blocks, I want to check the one-to-one correspondence. If I am putting this block on this, then you can see that EG is on AC. So we can say that EG side is corresponding to side AC. Now look on CD, what is it? GH side. So GH and CD are corresponding sides. Now we will check this side, FH. So on FH, what is the side? BD. So we can say that FH side is corresponding to side BD. Similarly, EF side is corresponding to side AB. In the same way, we can say that if we are saying E, F, H and G are the four angles of this square. So we can say that G, angle G is corresponding to angle C, and here, which is on H, means this corner, angle H is corresponding to angle D, angle F is corresponding to angle B, angle E is corresponding to angle A. So we will write like AB is corresponding to EF. So how we will write? Side AB is corresponding to side EF. Student, this is the symbol used for corresponding. Similarly, we can write all the sides. And for angles, we can write like G is corresponding to C. We can say angle G is corresponding to angle C. Similarly, we will write rest of all the angles. So this is the correspondence between the two congruent figures. We can also check the corresponding between different similar figures. Like if I am putting this triangle like this and this is like this. This is triangle ABC and this is triangle DEF. So students, now you can see that this triangle is like this and this is like this. So if I am putting this triangle the same like this triangle, now we can say that what is the corresponding side? AB is corresponding to DE, BC is corresponding to EF, AC is corresponding to DF. Clear? You should be careful if the shape is in opposite direction. So firstly you have to make sure the shape should be in the same direction, then you will take the correspondence. You will not take the correspondence like this, right? Whenever you have to take the correspondence, you will put the shapes in the same direction, then you will check the correspondence. Is it clear, students? Now students, we are going to discuss some properties of the similar figures. Number one property is, if the corresponding angles are congruent, then we can say that the figures are similar. Suppose we are having these two triangles, and if I am taking these corresponding angles as congruent, what are the corresponding angles? Do you know? A is corresponding to angle D, B is corresponding to angle E, and F is corresponding to angle C. So if it is given these corresponding angles are congruent, then we can say that these two figures are also similar, and vice versa. Vice versa means if it is given these two triangles are similar, so we can say that the corresponding angles will be congruent. Is that clear, students? Vice versa means if it is given, this situation is given, means the figures are similar, we can say that their corresponding angles are congruent. And if this situation is given, the corresponding angles are congruent, so we can say that the figures are similar. Now the property number two is, if the ratio of their corresponding sides are equal, then we can say that their figures are similar. Or if similar figures are there, we can say that ratio of their corresponding sides are equal. Students, you know what is ratio? Ratio is the comparison, and we are going to compare the corresponding sides. Like if I am taking this side BC, so its corresponding side will be FE. So first we will check the ratio CB ratio FE. It is 10 ratio 5. And we can write it like 10 by 5, it is equals to 2. Okay, now check the next ratio. AB, its corresponding side is DE. So now we will check its ratio. AB ratio DE is equals to 8 ratio 4, which is also equals to 2. Now we will check the third side. Third FD, corresponding side of FD is CA. We can write CA ratio FD. Okay, now it will be 6 ratio 3, that will be also equals to 2. So now we can say that the ratio of their corresponding sides are equal, so the figures are similar, right? And vice versa means if we are given the similar figures, we can say that ratio of their corresponding sides are also equal. Now this is the third property. Ratio of two pairs of corresponding sides and one pair of corresponding angles are equal. Means in the previous property we were having ratio of all the corresponding sides are equal. Now if the ratio of two pairs of corresponding sides are equal and one pair of corresponding angles are equal, then we can say that the figures are similar. Like in this example, you can see that this ED ratio BA, these two are corresponding sides, so I will take its ratio ED ratio BA, it is equals to 18 ratio 12. And you know, what is it? It will be 3 into 6 is 18 and 3 into 4 is 12. 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 2 is 4. 3 ratio 2, or you can say that 3 by 2. Next, second pair, FD. And what is the corresponding side is? CA. FD ratio CA, it is equals to 15 ratio 10. And 3, we will do it with 5. 5 into 3 is 15, 5 into 2. It is also 3 ratio 2. Okay, now we are done with two sides, two pairs of corresponding sides, and one pair of corresponding angle. You can see angle D is congruent to angle A. So, according to the property, we are having two pair of corresponding sides, same, and one angle is same. So, now we can say that the figures are similar, means these two triangles are similar, and vice versa means if we are having the similar figures, we can say that the ratio of two pairs of their corresponding side and one angle will be congruent, will be same, will be equal. Clear? Okay class, now we will do exercise 8.1, question number 1, 2 and 3 on book. In question number 1, just you have to identify the size and shape, and you have to tell whether the given figures are congruent or similar. In part number 1, you can see the size and shape are same, so these are congruent figures. While in part number 2, you can see their size is different, so these are similar. With the same pattern, you have to tell the similar and congruent figures in the rest of the parts. Now in question number 2, you have to tell the corresponding sides. Students, I have told you to check the corresponding sides. You have to put the figures in the same direction. When you will put the figures in the same direction, you will be easily able to find the corresponding sides. Just I am explaining this part number 2. If I am putting these with the same direction, you will check LN will be corresponding to NO, MN will be corresponding to NP, OP will be corresponding to LM. And if you want to make it more easy, you can take a rough page and you can paste these triangles, or you can put these triangles on each other, then you will check these two sides will be corresponding. Similarly, rest of the sides will be corresponding, which I have told you. Okay, in question number 3. Students, in question number 3, you have to tell the similar figures. Now we will use the properties to find the similarity between the figures. In part number 1, you are given only two angles. One in this triangle, angle 90 is given, but in this also 90 is given. But you can see that in the first triangle, 30 degree angle is given, but in this 60 is given. But the direction, when you will put the triangles in the same direction, this angle will be corresponding to this angle. Now, students, you know that the sum of angles of a triangle is 180. Check first triangle. In first triangle, angles are 90 and 30. So, subtract from 180. 90 minus 30. You will get the third angle as 60. This third angle will be 60. Now, in this triangle, again 90 and 60 is given. So, subtract from 180 minus 90 minus 60. You will get 30. In this way, you will find the remaining angles and you will check all the angles, corresponding angles of these two triangles are congruent. So, these triangles are similar. But in question number 2, it is clearly, you can see that the angles are not congruent. If the angles are not congruent, then the figures will not be similar. Because it is the property, if all the corresponding angles are congruent, then the figures will be similar. Same is the case with the part number 3. You can see that the angles, corresponding angles are not congruent. In this figure, all angles are of 90, but in this figure, all angles are of not of 90 degrees. Now in part number 4, these two triangles are similar according to the property. Now students, I am just going to tell you the part number 6. Rest of the parts, you can do it yourself. In part number 6, as no angle is mentioned, so you cannot tell the similar figures. You are not assured about the similarity of these two figures. So part number 6 will not be the similar figures. Thank you so much.